Good afternoon. Thank you for that introduction, Darren. I'm also glad to be joined by Ministers Fraser and Pettipaw-Taylor, as well as MPs Fillmore and Diab. Avant de commencer, je tiens à féliciter le Premier ministre Legault pour sa réélection. On a eu l'occasion de discuter au téléphone hier soir et je lui ai dit que j'étais heureux de continuer à travailler avec lui pour le bien des Québécois et de tous les Canadiens. Very grateful to be back here in Atlantic Canada today. Last week, I got to see firsthand the damage from the storm. And as I'd said, it was much worse than images from TV or the internet could show. Especially because I got to meet people who were affected. People like Sean and Amy, who had a neighbor's roof from two blocks over, fly through the air and slam into the side of their house. People like Mitch, who's worried about when he's going to be able to reopen his seafood shop and get back out on the water. People like Smokey in Puerto Basque, who barely escaped from his with his life as the waters tugged at and pulled away his home. Hearing their stories, understanding just how devastating this storm was and continues to be for the many tens of thousands of people without power still. Il reste beaucoup à faire et les forces armées canadiennes continuent d'apporter leur aide. On a prolongé leur déploiement d'une semaine dans toutes les provinces qui avaient demandé leur soutien. On a déployé environ 200 militaires de plus ici en Nouvelle-Écosse pour participer au nettoyage des débris, des routes et des propriétés. On va continuer d'être là pour aider les gens à traverser ces épreuves. C'est ça que les Canadiens font. On est là les uns pour les autres. Et on va continuer de l'être. I spoke with a lot of business owners who are taking stock and thinking about how to rebuild, thinking specifically about Barb, who I met last week in Stanley Bridge. She built her antique shop business over 25 years. Last week, when Hurricane Fiona hit, the force of the storm dragged the shop across the parking lot, destroying everything she had built in moments. Although there were still China figurines intact on shelves as they were brought across. Obviously, the water damage to record collections and other antiques was significant. And wondering how to rebuild, how to get the shop back to where it was before and prepare for the future was heavily on her and her husband's mind. Of course, she's not alone. Farmers saw their crops destroyed. Fishing communities across the region have seen boats damaged and gear lost, and wharves and harbors significantly affected. There are countless businesses in the region that are, even as they clean up, wondering how they're going to be able to rebuild. And so today, the federal government is announcing the new $300 million Hurricane Fiona Recovery Fund. This fund will be administered through Atlantic Canada Opportunities Agency, ACOA, and Développement économique Canada pour les régions du Québec, DEC, as well as other federal departments. This funding will support projects to repair and rebuild storm-damaged critical infrastructure, such as wharves, support the cleanup of fishing gear so that boats and marine life can once again safely navigate these waters, of course, help local businesses and communities rebuild and recover. En plus de cette nouvelle annonce, on a aussi d'autres mesures déjà en place pour aider les gens touchés par l'ouragan Fiona. On fournit de l'aide par le biais de l'accord d'aide financière en cas de catastrophe, AAFCC, en travaillant avec les provinces. Et comme je l'ai annoncé la semaine dernière, on accorde un allègement fiscal aux entreprises touchées. We know that it will take time to rebuild. The community support and the strength and, as Darren put it, the resilience of Atlantic Canadians is well known. These are communities where people look out for each other, where people step up for each other, where we're there to help each other out. And I can tell you, Canadians from coast to coast to coast are worried about their fellow Canadians here in Atlantic Canada, and will continue to step up and support, because the community support that I've witnessed here on the East Coast gives me not just hope, but assurance that everything will be done to build back even stronger. You're doing what Canadians have always done, helping each other out, and the federal government will be there with you every step of the way. Un peu plus tard aujourd'hui, je vais me rendre au Centre canadien de prévision des ouragans et on va parler du travail qu'ils font pour suivre les tempêtes et communiquer avec les services d'urgence. We know that accurate forecasting was a key part of saving lives during this devastating storm, and the work that the folks at Environment Canada and the Canadian Hurricane Service Centre continue to do is going to be more and more important in the coming years. C'est un travail important qui va sauver des vies et nous permettre de toujours être le mieux préparé possible face aux tempêtes qui, comme on le sait, vont malheureusement continuer à s'intensifier dans l'avenir. Merci beaucoup d'être ici aujourd'hui.